Hi guys, in this video I want to share with you some amazing benefits of intermittent fasting. Okay, intermittent fasting can act as a mild stress that triggers cellular adaptations and changes mainly in the brain but other places as well. Now we already talked about the benefits of intermittent fasting with your midsection, your weight, your performance with exercise, and the protection of your muscles so they don't become weak or destroyed. But check this out, it will increase this factor in the brain called brain-derived neurotrophic factor. Okay, what is that thing? Something in the brain that will increase the survival of existing neurons. Okay, those are brain cells. And it increases the growth of new neurons in the hippocampus, which is that part of the brain that gets destroyed when you have Alzheimer's. And that structure in the brain helps you, it's like a GPS, allows you to locate yourself in time and space. So if you're going outside, like, where did I park? Where did I put my keys? Where am I going? I can't follow directions, that type of thing. That would be destruction of the hippocampus. And in fact, insulin resistance will create problems with that structure. It just deprives it of oxygen and starves it as well. And then also it's involved in memory and learning, long-term memory, short-term memories. So this is something, if you know of someone that has Alzheimer's symptoms or dementia, you need to put them on this immediately. Protects against amyloid plaquing. That's the plaquing in the brain in Alzheimer's patients. It protects against that. It also will increase something called autophagy, which is like the mini garbage disposals of the cell, which it allows the toxins to come out of the body a lot easier and dispose of them, because patients with depression and Alzheimer's have a lot of excess toxic waste in the nerve cells, in the cells in general, so this will make it very, very clean. Intermittent fasting also will increase insulin responsiveness, and so again, if you have insulin resistance, prediabetes, this is what you need to do to actually fix that, all right? Put your comments below, tell me what you think. Hey, you probably already subscribed, but if you haven't, press this little button down below and I will keep you updated.